values needs to be invented by the people in the organization, not only by the management team. So it's not a top-down process where a management team decides, now we are going to change the core values and we will have those core values. It needs to be a bottom-up process. So people in the organization needs to be involved and engaged in creating core values and setting behavior guidelines for using them. So core values will have or make absolutely no sense without a statement where the company defines, for instance, if you use the core value respect, what does that mean? The input would then be that it depends on the company, it depends on the market, it depends on how large and skilled HR employees do you have in the organization. And the smaller the company is and the less impact the HR department has today, the smaller you need to start. Because what happens is that if you start working with talents internally in the organization, it's pretty easy to create a rumor in the organization about that we actually are working with talents, and that you can do totally without money. So talented people are actually a really good magnet for other talents. If other talent knows that talented people are working in the company, everyone wants to work there. Yes, how do you make talents happy? I think it's the same issue as for everyone else in the organization. Everyone wants to be seen. So if you can make the talent and employees feel that they are seen and that they are valuable for the company, you have come a long way in the talent management part. But you also need to help them to create their own destination within the company or from an external perspective. And even if you are working with, some people are really afraid of working with talents because if you invest a lot of money, they will leave and we have spent all this money without any purpose. But that's not true, because people who you are investing in, they will always be really, really good ambassadors for the company. And then immediately you have good ambassadors for the company outside the company. And that's really valuable from a branding perspective. I think that CEOs that realize that talent can contribute to the bottom line that you are talking about, they are the winners, and they need to have a strategy for that. And if you, in the end, everything ends back to what people dream about, what the company dreams about being in the future, and also if that is the same dream as the talents have in the organization, then it's really good. So if you can create a common dream for people in the organization where we want to be, a destination in the future, then you don't need to do that much with the talents. They will be here because they believe in the same why as the company is doing.